Welcome back to Lake Lanier. Just a couple of minutes to go before the start of the men's Canadian doubles over 500 metres. And this features the Olympic champions Martin Marinov and Blagovest Stoyanov, who won the bronze medal in 1992 for Bulgaria. The Olympic champions, though, are Alexander Masekeyov and Dmitry Dovgalyonik, who won the title, as I said, for 1992 for the Equipe Unifiée, the Commonwealth of Independent States, but today represents Belarus. Well, also to look out for are the Moldavians, Nikolai Jouravski and Victor Reneiski, who did the Olympic double over 500 and 1,000 in Seoul in 1988, and these days represent Moldavia. Well, I can tell you, as they begin to line up, here are the men from Belarus in lane two. These are your Olympic champions trying to hold on to the title. Just about 60 seconds to start the regatta now. We're getting some very fast times. There's a following wind, which is really improving things, but it's not making life easy for the men in lanes one, two, and three. And these are the Germans looking for gold once again, having won the C-2 1000 yesterday. Dittmer and Kirchbach going for the double. Trying to stop them are the world champions. Here they are. This is Kolonics and Horvath for Hungary, who were third in the world. They're in lane number four, just sliding in now ahead of the pink boat. Then for Romania, it's the two 28-year-olds, Andreev and Obreja, who were only sixth in the world last year, but have clearly improved. The 1988 Olympic champions there from Moldavia these days in lane six. For Spain in lane seven, this is Alfredo and Oleg Shelestenko. And then for Russia, two men who were fourth in the world 12 months ago, this is Kabanov and Konovalov. And finally for Slovakia in lane number nine, Parish and Orots, who have on paper quite a lot to do to try and get into the medals. So the lineup then for the C2 500. Watch out for the Germans in lane three in the pink boat, looking for double gold, and the world champions just above them from Hungary, who'll be trying to add Olympic gold to last year's title in Duisburg. And they're the Germans who are going out, Dittmer and Kirchbach from Germany, from Neubrandenburg and Potsdam respectively, and they at the moment are being outpaced by both the Belarusian Olympic champions and also the Hungarians. And it's the Hungarians now who've got the lead. It's the two Hungarians who are already Gheorghe Kolonics and Csaba Horvath, who between them have got 15 gold medals in world championships, who are trying to make every paddle stroke a winning one as we come down towards 250 metres. And they lead the echelon at the moment. Also going pretty well, the Moldavians, who are just about in second place. There they are, the Moldavians, who were Olympic champions in 1988. Jouravski is 31, Reneiski is 29, and they're really giving the Hungarians a race for their money. In between those two are Romania, just on the right of your picture, but you can't see the lanes out. The Germans are being really outpaced at the moment. Dittmer and Kirchbach came with a late charge yesterday to win the 1,000 meter race, but they've got it to do now, and so have the Olympic champions from Belarus. And it's the Moldavian Olympic champions from 88 against the world champions of 1995, and it's the Olympic champions from Moldavia who are at the moment just about ahead of the Hungarians, but it's very close. Who wants it most? And the Hungarians coming back now. The Germans trying to get into third, but the Romanians have that. The Hungarians, it's on the surge. Hungary get there, I think. Very, very close. I think Hungary will get that ahead of Moldavia, with Romania third and Germany just about fourth there. The Hungarians think they've got there as well. You could see both men lean back in the stern to shoot the bow forward. Look at this, closest to you Hungary, furthest away Moldavia. It's right on the paddle surge. Wow, that's close. But I think it's Hungary closest to us, and there the Romanians pushing the Germans into fourth. And then the Bulgarians coming in fifth place. Here from the reverse angle, so closest to you. Well, it's one for the photograph. That's not a precise line, and neither is the compressed air bubbly line absolutely precise. But if I have to give a decision, and it's, yeah, well, they've given it to them. Hungary have got it. They've got the gold medal to follow Rita Coben's success from early this morning, and Hungary now have two gold medals for their morning's work. But it really is millimeter.